I think a lot of folks who work in this, who work in that field, in both parties, I'm pretty sure Rick is an exception to this, think he thought it was a mistake to go out and make a statement before the facts were clear. He went out and made a statement condemning this tweet from the Cairo embassy that the administration then said was a mistake, and it was then deleted, and referring to the death of a consular official when I think he didn't realize that we didn't know that the ambassador had been killed, and I think people were surprised that he jumped out like that.
What do you think, Rick? You think that it was not necessarily a mistake, right?
Well, Ben just called it jumping out. I think we got to look at the facts. The simple fact is that the Cairo embassy issued a statement that was not approved by Hillary Clinton. Hillary Clinton looked at the statement, actually, and said, no, this is a weak statement. This should not go out. It went out anyway. 15 hours later, Mitt Romney decides this violence is escalating. It's getting out of hand. He says something. The president of the United States, President Obama, doesn't say anything for 15 hours. And when he does say something, his first words are to chastise Mitt Romney. I don't think that you should be characterizing this as jumping out in front.
I think it's sort of odd that you're saying that this statement from the Cairo embassy was the fault of the president of the United States, but not the fault of the Secretary of State. I mean, I understand there's this thing of positioning Hillary Clinton against Obama, which it may well at times be true.
No, that's not what I'm saying. First of all, if you're the president of the United States, you have to own up to the fact of escalating and developing violence. For 15 hours, nothing is being said. I think that we're missing one point here. When the White House is silent, that's a weak message. Silence and a lack of a message is really a problem. And I think that's what Mitt Romney was saying 15
hours
later.
Romney could have gone out and said that.
Look, some people may think that Mitt Romney jumped out after 15 hours. I actually think that we should have an American president who absolutely sees developing problems and says, I'm going to enter the situation and I'm going to try to calm it down. I don't think it's too much, Wolf, to say that if the president of the United States would have jumped in early and said something.
Rick, how would he calm it down?
Well, you use the bully pulpit. I think just by asking that question, there's a sense in that question that the American presidency doesn't have power or the White House doesn't have power.
I think we should be paying less attention to these kinds of behaviors and activities. And at the same time, you're kind of saying that the president's silence increased the violence. So what's the president going to come out and say? Don't make people angry, which is what the embassy said anyway. I don't understand what you're suggesting that you should have done.
Okay, so let me be clear. First of all, I agree with you that some stupid movie should not be an issue. If you look at what Al Jazeera is saying in the region, they're saying that this movie had nothing to do with this violence. But I think to answer your question, the president of the United States can immediately come out and call on the Egyptian government to calm the situation down, call on the protesters to remember a variety of different points. I think you find a way to utilize the bully pulpit faster than 15 hours later.
Meanwhile, Romney did politicize.
Ben, we're going to take a break, but go ahead and respond to that. Then we'll take a quick break.
I mean, I would say, if only Rick were still Romney's spokesman. I think what Rick said just now made a lot of sense. It isn't exactly what Romney said.